Buddy Troy here. If you follow me on Instagram or if you run across me on the Facebook Kemper Praise and Worship page, you've heard by now and follow my journey of ditching all my Strymon wet effects, so delay, the timeline, reverb, big sky, mods, Mobius, in favor of the Kemper remote and going all Kemper for wet effects. I still run the like a compressor pog, three drives, Strymon Flint, and a vibrato pedal in front of the Kemper. I didn't ditch those, but I'm using all Kemper internal effects for delays, reverbs, and mods. It was definitely a tough transition. I had to rebuild all my presets, and for me it was a decently large learning curve because I knew the Strymon stuff so well. But I want to give a shout out to Joseph Wu, Evan Hudson, Tommy Ziggers, Dallas Klemick, Jeff Monroe, Cody Hike, Colton, forgot your last name, buddy. Bunch of guys on the Kemper Praise and Worship Facebook page that just helped me through the transition. I had tons of questions. I'm pretty happy though. So the Kemper gets all the way there for delays, just as good as the timeline, in my opinion. About 95% there on the big sky, or on the reverbs when compared to the big sky. And I'm really, really happy. And it allowed me to do some things, freeing up some cash to buy some other stuff that I wanted, custom in-ear molds that should be here soon. I just picked up a PRS DGT guitar for the prison stuff that I'm going to be doing next year some more. And that's stuff that I wouldn't have spent money on otherwise. I don't like to dig out of my personal savings account for gear. So it was pretty cool to be able to do that. And I'm really, really happy. But the biggest thing is I'm now running stereo on the Kemper. It's amazing. It's just like, totally blew my mind the difference and how worth it is. So what I'm going to do here is, instead of doing a big like rig run through and stuff, which I'll do in the future, but I'm just going to play a bunch of the songs that we're doing at church right now with the presets that I've made up for the Kemper, with no backing tracks, just guitar totally exposed so you can hear them. And I guess judge for yourself, is the Kemper really good enough? Are the reverbs really that good? Are the delays really that good? And judge for yourself. If you have any questions, comments, please leave them in the comments section below. Happy to help you if you're on the same journey or if you have specific questions about the Kemper itself. But is it really that good? Yeah, it's really that good. Hope you enjoy it.